Vietnam. Let's go. Only 30 hours later. So crossing the street is kind of like a mixture of Frogger and Russian roulette. Once again, this is where I realise how unfit I am. Delivery. The view from the mountains on this drive is just incredible. I mean, it literally just goes on as far as you can see. But Paul, who's a little bit afraid of heights, is not enjoying it so much.
Now we've got a place to call our own. This modern life. Wilson? Good?
Plan for tonight then, Sophie?
We're just gonna walk around the old town and look at lanterns and,
yeah,
and get drunk as well. Get a little bit merry before it all shuts off.
Go and get drunk.
Oh my god, you see that?
lean back, Sophie. What do you do when we need to order a drink, so?
Please not beer.
So this guy is trying to get his job at the back of his motorbike to go to a bar that is apparently still serving beer, but no one else is serving beer.
Oh, sorry, we're
going to do this.
It's 9 a.m. and now we've got to get up and go get our suits fitted at the tailor's. And I'm so rough.
Just come to pick up our suits with the worst hangover in the world. But at least it's not raining. Literally from nowhere, rain. The airport, we're now leaving and heading off to Saigon. Another day, another airplane.
It's terrifying.
It's a pie. It's a pie.
Bloody pissed them off.
Before we came away, Mum made me a promise that I wouldn't go anywhere near scooters or motorbikes over here.
Sorry, Mum. Hey, Chris, I got you dancing to Britney Spears last night.
Hit me, baby, one more time.